Buckley. It was Sarah. She keeps bursting into tears and she can't sing. Sarah, what is it? Aren't you well?
I'm so sorry, but it's singing about honeysuckle. It makes me very sad.
Here, yes.
Well, anyways, it's condescending all of liberty. We'll wake up bright and early on Sunday morning. And Sarah, may I see you for a moment, please?
Yes, Mrs. Buckley.
Now she's going to push, kicked out of the choir and out of her home. And silly Willie, too. Crybaby Sarah!
Don't you talk like that about my sister!
She can be sad if she wants to. It's a terrible thing to lose your home.
I'll say what I like. And what are you going to do about it, silly Willie?
I'll show you what. Anytime. You and what army?
My father says your father.
You be quiet, Leo.
Fine, then. I'll say it. Willie's father doesn't stand a chance against old Van Redley. He doesn't have the nerve to stand up to him.
My father says you're all going to the poorhouse.
That's where you belong anyway. No money and no breeding. That's what my mom says.
Money isn't everything.
Not as long as you have plenty of it. If you don't, you might as well just give it up.
And this counts too. My papa says the Willings are good people and don't deserve to be treated that way. How would you like if you suddenly lost your home?
Well, that couldn't possibly happen to us. Besides, my papa and Mr. Van Redley belong to the same club, and Mr. Willings doesn't belong to any.
Clubs don't matter. My father says what good you do, and what side that matters.
You'll never get anywhere. I'm going to Eton in the fall.
Righto, he's going to Eton. That's where all the royals go. You couldn't even get through the seventh entrance. Just look at yourself.
And you know, Sarah must get her clothes from the church giveaway. She always looks like something out of a rag
bag. I can't believe you're all saying things like this. Sarah's mother makes her clothes and she always looks nice. You should be ashamed of yourselves, all of you.
You wouldn't be talking like that if it were you.
Come on, Willie, put her up. I dare you.
Give it to me, little boy. Show me the boss.
Don't you touch me!
I don't understand at all.
afraid we are friends.
I'm sure that I heard two voices. I can't half imagine them both.
We are not fooling you, dear children. We are truly here. Please to turn around.
Patience, please. Humble self will whip you up some Wiener Schnitzel.
Oh, Wiener Schnitzel.
Excuse, please, for eavesdropping, but could not help but overhear. Appear to have very serious problem.
Yes, my family. We do.
Well then, if we're to help you, first you must help us. Very calmly describe to us your problem, and we'll see how we can fix it. But you must hurry. Your parents will soon become worried, and they'll come with that poor little sexton, Mr. Grout. He's such a nervous fellow, just the sight of us would send him into palpitations. Now then, your turn.
You see, our dad's not working, though he's looking very hard. There's not a lot of jobs to be had for historians. It has him very worried, and he's feeling great defeat. To take care of Willie, Mummy, and me. Our clothes are very old, our pantry's rather slim, and to be very honest, the picture's rather grim. And to top it all off is Van Grudgley.
Van Grudgley.
Van Grudgley.
Snively Van Grudgley.
Snively Van Grudgley.
Run along and we'll get back to you soon.
Will you really?
Of course we will. We always keep our promises, but not a word of it, not to anyone, right?
Right.
All right, good show then. Until later.
Ta-ta.
We'll be back.
Oh, children. Oh, I wish heaven had found you. Were you terribly frightened?
No, there's nothing to be frightened of here. Well, not much.
Your mother Fairbird. Thank you very much, Mr. Grounds.
Yes, indeed. Thank you.
How did you ever get locked in here?
I bumped my head when I fell down. Nobody noticed I wasn't with the others.
Come on, Rachel.
I really have to check these old books. They're in horrible shape. A body could get lost in here for days.
Properties. and its mountains, and hiding all the taxable funds.
All those taxable funds.
But I refuse to feel guilty for using my ability. A man can make his fortune as he can. To feel guilty for using my ability. A man should make his fortune any way he can. I got a really good accountant with a calculating brain, and all it to my fortune any way that I can.
And he'll
add
to his fortune any way.
Family.
chance for me. No point in making punch if I'm the only one in the bunch. So it's all alone, I'll have to own. Another inevitable, gloomy and irritable, thoroughly terrible Christmas. Another Christmas alone.
You do that.
there, Sarah. But we have to do the best we can.
Try not to be afraid, my dears. We're going to be alright. We'll always have a place to sleep and refuge from the night. Don't give in to fear, my dears. That's the worst thing we could do. We have each other, that's what counts. No matter what else, we've got amounts of love and faith and gentle hugs. Though the wolf may give the door some tugs, Mommy and Daddy will keep it closed. Don't worry, we'll keep it closed.
But what if that's not enough?
Say, it's a bit of a draft in here. It's getting chilly. Did anyone else do with a nice hot cup of tea?
Tea? Most excellent idea.
Don't we have any beer?
I'm sorry, tea will just have to do for now. Indeed, my dear. I take it you're partial. Then you may do the honors.
I love jam tarts too.
But don't take all of them.
Can I have whipped cream?
You may.
Well, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea to chase away the shadows and the cold. A hot cup of chop with sugar and cream is a custom we enjoy from times of old.
In the East, the ceremony is one of our finer arts.
In Germany, we like a tea with plenty of germ tarts.
Yes, plenty of germ tarts.
Would someone kindly pass the whipped cream?
Oh, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea. Perhaps we'll even have two. Oh, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea among friends. While we cogitate on what we're going to do, we need to find a way to show.
The power that can help.
that, we take measures immediately. It would be unwise to wait.
I see that, of course. Tossing them out so close to Christmas seems a bit over the top, don't you know? We could wait until afterwards, Sneak.
Do not sneak!
Whatever!
My friend, when it comes to the really important things like money, what? Never be kind. He gives people the wrong idea about things. Well, if we do that, then everything will go wrong.
But the will, it does give them the house.
But if there is no house, then everything becomes, how do you say, academic, no? You have no other choice. I shall go and make arrangements for the glorious moment when the wrecking ball arrives. One good hit, and goodbye, house. Goodbye, problem. I shall leave you with that happy thought.
How do you get them? Don't you lose your minds and stop the frog?
I've got it. We'll give them a nice dose of memory. Can we do that one way?
Happy to have a magic tea on hand.
Why can't I think of clever things like that?
It's just not your nature, old boy. The brains, you're the brawn.
Is that good?
Most certainly. Muscle necessary when brain absent.
Now, we'll send him back to a time when he's a poor little rich boy. All alone. Painful, yes, but we shan't overdo it. Now, Fafnir, do you have any of your thirsty dust on hand?
Yeah, right here.
All right. Very good show, old boy. Wait for my signal.
Cease fight, of course. I can't wait. Not even a day. That look anymore. Pin! That look untied humor. Can't have that.
Who are you trying to convince here, boy?
What? Who's there?
Sworn I heard somebody.
Now.
Well, a little more than nicely said. He can have the rest of it. And with my
an anniversary.
I'm terribly sorry, but I won't be able to do the essay.
And why is that, young sir? I hope you're not being impertinent.
Oh, no, ma'am. I'm just... have no family to write about. There's just...
Yes, well, I do see. I'm sorry. Just write me a nice essay about your house, where you live. Yes, that would be nice.
Yes, ma'am.
That'll be good. Snivy lives in an old haunted castle.
That's not so. It's not haunted. It's just very old. That's all.
It's sure it's haunted, and everybody's afraid to go near there.
It is so haunted. It's haunted by the rain. Ghostly dragon!
Now I'm sending you home to write that essay twice as long.
500 words?
500 words.
That's not fair.
Fairness, what would you know about fairness? Furthermore, I expect you to copy the first 15 pages of the Common Book of Prayer. Perhaps that will compensate for your uncharitable behavior. Now I must seek out poor Master Van Virgin and pray that he's not cast himself into a river.
15 pages? That would take hours!
It's all Snively's fault.
We'll surely get him back.
If he shows faith again, we'll change it for him.
Dare say you don't deserve it.
trap, you know? I think if you were able to make apologies and make amends for some of the unkind things you've done, you'd be able to have a second chance. Are you ready for that?
Well...
Ja, order nine snuffing!
Hatcher, please do not be so barbarian. You gentlemen have a chance to speak.
Sorry.
Well, I'm tired of being lonely, disliked. I want people to like me. I want to have friends. I want to have fun. If I don't have family, at least I can still have friends.
Good show. With a brain like yours, I'm sure you can make amends. And you can start with the willing. Call off your Frenchmen and give them back their home, like it was meant to be years ago.
All right, I'll do it. I really will. Watch me.
Good show, old boy. You will be back on track in no time. Now, I think we have a surprise for you.
A surprise? For me?
I think he's ready, gentlemen. What do you say?
Absolutely.
Most possible, he is ready.
All right, I want you to go fetch the old family Bible from where it's been gathering dust on the top shelf.
That thing up there, haven't looked in years.
We've noticed. Now, open up to the center and you'll find a document.
Yes.
There, that's it.
I say, it's a family tree. My family tree.
Please to find self and trace back to the honorable departed mother.
There I am, Albert Snively George III. And there's my dear late partner, Albert Snively George II. Oh, and there's my dear late partner. Don't remember her well. Beautiful name, too. Alicia Victoria Frederica Willing Van Gogh. Willing? Willing, why I say, her maiden name was Willing!
I think he's got it.
Most possible, if he's not it.
But that means...
That means you were about to tear down the home of your only living relative, your cousin, Redley Willing, and his wife and children, Amanda, Sari, and Willie Willing, right about their ears.
Oh no, I've got to stop it. Sneak and his wrecking ball is on the way. I'll call for my car. Oh no, it won't get there in time. Oh no, we'll never be able to get there in time. What will I do?
I think it's time for a little dragon transport.
Crutches gone.
gone too far this time. Look, there's the wrecking ball. What will the Willings family do? This is their true downfall.
Uh-huh. Wee wee. Too late, this little house will be its fate. The grand eviction now befall. Ha ha, here comes the wrecking ball.
Get nervous now.
We're cousins. First cousins.
Cousins? You and
and your dear late partner, Adam Victor Frederick Ewing, were brother and sister. I'm ready to do whatever ever forgive me. I didn't blame you, could. But do you think you could?
I really had no idea. I remember Papa mentioning his sister, and her name was Alicia, but she was lost to the family when she married. Grandpapa didn't approve, you see, and I never knew who married her, or that she had a little boy. All I knew was that, well, she and her husband both died young. This would be in the family Bible, of course, but it's lost.
No, it isn't. You think it was right here, and you think it was always right there for me. Here, have a look. Oh, I don't deserve to be forgiven. I'm such a dreadful, awful fellow.
No, Cousin Snively. Everyone deserves a second chance. Even you. Isn't that so, everyone?
Yes!
You can change and become a splendid fellow. And your family and new family cousins will help you.
I'll make up for all of the bad things I've done. Really, just watch me. Only
what?
Do you think I could spend this Christmas with you? It's just, I've never had a real Christmas. At least not one that I can remember.
Well, of course you can, Cousin Snively. You can come for Christmas and Easter and Guy Fawkes Day and Sunday lunches if you like. Isn't that so, children? Welcome back to the family.
And I'll be glad to sit down with you. Together, we'll sort out everything immense. You know, this truly is remarkable. It's a miracle.
Thank you.
She keeps bursting into tears and she can't sing.
Sarah, what is it? Aren't you well?
I'm so sorry, but it's singing about honeysuckle. It makes me very sad.
That's where all the royals go. You couldn't even get to the seventh entrance.
Yeah, yeah, you did it, Ovan. But don't be afraid. We are friends.
I'm sure that I heard two voices. I can't half imagine them both.
We are not fooling you, dear children. We are truly here. Please to turn around.
Patience, please. Humble self will whip you up some Wiener Schnitzel.
Oh, Wiener Schnitzel.
Excuse, please, for eavesdropping, but could not help but overhear. Appear to have very serious problem.
Yes, my family, we do.
Well then, if we're to help you, first you must help us. Very calmly describe to us your problem, and we'll see how we can fix it. But you must hurry. Your parents will soon become worried, and they'll come with that poor little sexton, Mr. Grout. He's such a nervous fellow, just the sight of us would send him into palpitations. Now then, your turn.
You see, our dad's not working, though he's looking very hard. There's not a lot of jobs to be had for historians. It has him very worried, and he's feeling great defeat. To take care of Willie, Mummy, and me. Our clothes are very old, our pantry's rather slim, and to be very honest, the picture's rather grim. And to top it all off, this Van Grudgley.
Yeah.
run along, and we'll get back to you soon.
Will you really?
Of course we will. We always keep our promises, but not a word of it, not to anyone, right?
Right.
All right, good show then. Until later.
Ta-ta.
We'll be back.
Oh, children. Oh, I wish nobody had found you. Were you terribly frightened?
No, there's nothing to be frightened of here. Well, not much.
Your mother, Fairbird. Thank you very much, Mr. Brown.
Yes, indeed. Thank you.
How did you ever get locked in here?
I bumped my head when I fell down. Nobody noticed I wasn't with the others.
Come on, Rachel.
I really have to check these old books. They're in horrible shape. A body could get lost in here for days.
Stocks and bonds. Amazing!
There's so much fun in counting all those lovely dividends mounting and hiding all those taxable funds.
All those taxable funds.
But I refuse to feel guilty for using my ability. A man should make his fortune as he can. But I refuse to feel guilty. Calculating brain and all it to my fortune any way that I can.
And he'll
let
you rich fortune any way that I can.
Now then, team.
Do not sneak!
Whatever! Just how do you propose to carry out my orders?
There are so many methods I can use to extract the weeds from the premises. We could try a little fire, just a teeny weeny blade. The quick results of fire down the seas that you will make. Or I could try something a little more subtle, something without great precaution or recall.
No termites, no peas. Much too hot here. And fire's much too obvious.
Well, how about the little floating devil will suspect? Or maybe something more than that and not some great respect. A big glory load of garbage on the porch. That could the boy the use of the torch.
No. Much too hard to clean up.
You are a very, very difficult man to please. But there are lots more ways. The button is the squeeze. A little broken glass, some gravel and some dent. The dog will bark, the door is shut, and you and me will say, soon enough, they'll be out on the street. So that fatigue, your tooth, the sweet. They will be gone in a week. Or my name is a dog, okay, let's meet.
Celebrate madly.
I am looking for a soldier. Hi, soldier at home, yes?
Yes,
to sleep and refuge from the night. Don't give in to fear, my dears, that's the worst thing we could do. We have each other, that's what counts, no matter what else. We forge amounts of love and faith and gentle hugs. Though the wolf may give the door some tugs, Mommy and Daddy will keep it closed. Don't worry, we'll keep it closed.
But what if that's not enough?
I'm sorry, tea will just have to do for now.
I love jam tarts too.
But don't take all of them.
Can I have whipped cream?
You may.
Well, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea to chase away the shadows and the cold. A hot cup of chow with sugar and cream is a custom we enjoy from times of old.
In the East, the ceremony is one of our finer arts.
In Germany, we like a tea with plenty of jam tarts.
Yes, plenty of jam tarts.
Would someone kindly pass the whipped cream?
Oh, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea. Perhaps we'll even have two. Oh, there's nothing like a hot cup of tea among friends. While we cogitate on what we're going to do, we need to find a way to show.
We are and we know what to do, and we're
we take measures immediately. It would be unwise to wait.
I see that, of course, but tossing them out so close to Christmas seems a bit over the top, don't you know? We could wait until afterwards, Sneak.
Do not sneak!
Whatever!
My friend, when it comes to the really important things like money, one never be kind. He gives people the wrong idea about things. Well, if we do that, then everything will go wrong.
But the will, it does give them the house.
But if there is no house, then everything becomes, how do you say, academic, no? You have no other choice. I shall go and make arrangements for the glorious moment when the wrecking ball arrives. One good hit, and goodbye, house. Goodbye, problem. I shall leave you with that happy thought.
How do you think it's a... Don't you lose your minds and stop the frog?
I've got it. We'll give them a nice dose of memory. Can we do that, one way?
Happy to have a magic tea on hand.
Why can't I think of clever things like that?
It's just not your nature, old boy. The brains, your brawn.
Is that good?
Most certainly. Muscle necessary when brain absent.
Now, we'll send him back to a time when he's a poor little rich boy. All alone. Painful, yes, but we shan't overdo it. Now, Fafnir, do you have any of your thirsty dust on hand?
Yeah, right here.
All right. Very good show, old boy. Wait for my signal.
Cease fight, of course. I can't wait. Was even a dead. That look terrible. Pin! That look untied humor. Can't have that.
Who are you trying to convince, dear boy?
What? Who's there?
Sworn I heard somebody. Now.
Please, the wine was excellent, Will. What?
pay close attention to proper English and grammar usage. Are there any questions before you're dismissed?
Mom?
Yes, Master Van Grosley.
I'm terribly sorry, but I won't be able to do the essay.
And why is that, young sir? I hope you're not being impertinent.
Oh, no, ma'am. I'm just... have no family to write about. There's just...
Yes, well, I do see. I'm sorry. Just write me a nice essay about your house, where you live. Yes, that would be nice.
Yes, ma'am.
That would be good. Snively lives in an old haunted castle.
That's not so. It's not haunted. It's just very old. That's all.
It's sure it's haunted, and everybody's afraid to go near there.
It is so haunted. It's haunted by the rain. Ghostly dragon!
Children, that's enough! I can't imagine what sort of things you learn at home.
Furthermore, I expect you to copy the first 15 pages of the Common Book of Prayer. Perhaps that will compensate for your uncharitable behavior. Now I must see a poor Master Van Virgin and pray that he's not cast himself into a river.
15 pages? That would take hours!
It's all Snively's fault.
We'll surely get him back.
If he shows faith again, we'll change it for him.
Ready? amends for some of the unkind things you've done, you'd be able to have a second chance. Are you ready for that?
Well...
You're old and not snuggly!
Hatter, please do not be so barbarian. Be gentle and chance to speak.
Sorry.
Well,
I'm tired of being lonely, disliked. I want people to like me. I want to have friends. I want to have fun. If I don't have family, at least I can still have friends.
Good show. With a brain like yours, I'm sure you can make amends. And you can start with the willing. Call off your Frenchmen and give them back their home, like it was meant to be years ago.
All right, I'll do it. I really will. Watch me.
Good show, old boy. You will be back on track in no time. Now, I think we have a surprise for you.
A surprise? For me?
I think he's ready, gentlemen. What do you say?
Absolutely.
Most possible, he is ready.
All right, I want you to go fetch the old family Bible from where it's been gathering dust on the top shelf.
That thing up there, haven't looked in years.
We've noticed. Now, open up to the center and you'll find a document.
Yes.
There, that's it.
I say, it's a family tree. My family tree.
Please to find self and trace back to the honorable departed mother.
There I am, Albert Snively George III. And there's my dear late partner, Albert Snively George II. Oh, and there's my dear late partner. Don't remember her well. Beautiful name, too. Alicia Victoria Frederica Willing Van Gertie. Willing? Why, I say, her maiden name was Willing!
I think he's got it.
Most possible, if he's got it. But that means...
That means you were about to tear down the home of your only living relative, your cousin, Redley Willing, and his wife and children, Amanda, Sari, and Willie Willing, right about their ears.
Oh, no, I've got to stop it. Sneak and his wrecking ball is on the way. I'll call for my car. Oh, no, it won't get there in time. Oh, no, we'll never be able to get there in time. What will I do?
I think it's time for a little dragon transport.
To
You're fired. He is your chair.
Everyone deserves a second chance. Even you, isn't that so?